Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're all doing fine. So this is an emergency video, my friends, because Bitcoin currently is breaking below important supports. So we are looking right now at a bearish scenario for Bitcoin because we are breaking significant support levels, and also we're gonna have to check the similarities that we still have from our bull market back in 2013. So we're gonna analyze that again, and of course also have a look in different indicators that are suggesting that you should buy as much Bitcoin as possible on the way towards our bearish targets. Because this bigger correction that we now finally got after about 6 months of just pushing towards new all-time highs is of course healthy and also was expected. I was telling you already in many videos ago that since we got a sell signal in the monthly time frame, it's very likely that we could retrace towards important levels in the bigger time frames before we accumulate again and then again head towards new all-time highs. And since I still think that 65k is not the cycle top, we're gonna have a look where we could accumulate again more Bitcoin to then ride it up towards our potential cycle top later this year. So we're gonna start first here quickly in the lower time frames for Bitcoin here. In the 4 hour, you can see that currently we are breaking below this support that we had here from this potential falling wedge. If we're gonna break out to the downside here and confirm now this new resistance here at $45,000, then in my opinion, it's very likely that this potential bullish pattern is denied for now and we are heading towards sub 40K levels. So it's gonna be very interesting to see here in the next coming hours if we're gonna remain below $45,000, because in that case, that will mean that we're not gonna see here anytime soon a breather to the upside. But of course, if Bitcoin is able again to close 4 hour candles above 45K, so above this support trend line, then I think that we are in for a nice breather towards potentially 53 to 54K. And yes, I am still in my long position. I can easily add more into my long position once we are reaching our bearish targets that in my opinion are very likely to be reached. And I'm just gonna prepare this long position for this potential breather that is coming sooner or later. So here in the lower time frames, we are seeing that Bitcoin currently is very oversold in my own indicator, and we could get another buy signal very soon here. So that's why I'm expecting here a little bounce to the upside. And if we go over into the 3 hour time frame, you can see that also we have now a big bullish divergence. So we have a higher low in the RSI and a lower low in the price action. So in the 3 hour time frame, we are having right now a bullish divergence, and that's why in my opinion, it's very likely that we could get this breather towards my target of around 53K in the next coming hours or days. And we can also do here a Fibonacci retracement from the last high that we had here, so this lower high compared to this one over here at 65k, and with this lower high that we created here and the potential bottom that we could have here, let's assume that $42,000 is the bottom for now and we're gonna get now a breather, then the potential target here of a breeder would be up here at the 0.618 Fibonacci retracement level, so at around $52,000, and therefore maybe even have some wicks to the upside towards the 200 moving average here at around 55K. But I think here at around 54K, we already will face a lot of resistance, because here also previously we had a lot of support and this can act now as a very strong resistance. So if we're getting a breather and continue to create here lower lows and lower highs, then I think 53 to 54K is a very realistic target where we then could confirm again our downtrend and create another lower high, which of course will mean that we are heading lower here in the next coming days. So if we're getting here in the short term a breather, watch out for my target still here at around 53 to 54k. This is also where I potentially going to close this long position if we are getting there a lower high and a big rejection. Otherwise, I'm gonna ride it up, of course, but as soon as we're reaching this 53 to 54k, I'm gonna put a stop loss in profits and then later on look again for good long opportunities, because I still don't want to short Bitcoin. I don't want to short Bitcoin during a bull market, but of course when we are seeing a downtrend in the daily time frame, of course you can also do some money with shorting Bitcoin. So if you want to short Bitcoin over on Bybit or Femex, wait maybe until we are getting a breather and then scale in some shorts. If you want to open up an account over on Bybit or Femex like this, you can also make some money while we are going down. Then make sure to sign up with my links that you find down below here in the video description, because they will give you some bonus if you sign up with my links. And now let's switch over into the daily time frame, because as you can see, Bitcoin is still closing daily candles below all the important moving averages up here at around 54k and also below the EMA ribbons. So we are in a downtrend here in the daily time frame. Money flow is also negative, but as you can see, we could get here very soon a buy signal. I think latest then we're gonna see this breather towards 54k, and then of course we're gonna see what will happen up here in these regions, if we're able to push higher and the correction is done, or if we're gonna create another lower high and continue our downtrend. And something very important to see here is that we are coming very close to the 200 daily moving average currently here at around $39,000. So if we're gonna repeat something similar like in 2013, then here at the 200 daily moving average, we should be buying back in Bitcoin, because in 2013, this was also more or less where we then consolidated, we bottomed out, and then from here on bounced again to the upside and continued our parabolic rise up towards the real cycle top of that bull market in 2013. So we can go back in time and have a look what exactly happened in 2013. So this was here the real cycle top in December 2013 at $1,160. And before we reach that parabolic target, we had here a lower local top right here at $260. And what happened here is that here first we got a Pi cycle top based on the caretaker Pi cycle Bitcoin top indicator. So exactly like we had right now at around 60k, also this signal flashed here in 2013. This was a good sell opportunity, because afterwards we started the dump, we consolidated again, and then continued our parabolic bull market towards the real cycle top. And that's why I'm telling you, my friend, that I think that this bull market that we're seeing right now is very similar to the one in 2013, and that's why we have to look what happened afterwards. Because after this local cycle top that we had here, you can see that we came straight back down towards the 200 daily moving average, and we stayed along this moving average for quite some time before we definitely bottomed out here and then continued our bull market. So if we're gonna repeat something similar like we had in 2013, then I'm expecting that we are coming down towards the 200 daily moving average, potentially consolidate and accumulate during that phase before we continue to go again parabolic to the upside towards our real cycle top for this bull market. So that's why, in my opinion, buying here at the 200 daily moving average, so at the current time at around 40k, is a perfect buy opportunity to ride this thing up once we're taking off again. And we can have a look also here into the weekly time frame what happened, because you can see that also here we came below the 20 weekly moving average. So right now we are also trading below the 20 weekly moving average, and you can see during this correction and accumulation phase we stayed below the 20 weekly moving average and it acted as a resistance. Once we started again to close weekly candles above the 20 weekly moving average, that was then the signal that we are out of the woods. and we will go towards new all-time highs. So afterwards, you can see that we started again our parabolic moves towards the real cycle top. And even after the real cycle top, we had a bear market that brought us down right at the top of this previous local top that we had here. So if we're gonna repeat something similar, Bitcoin will not only go to completely new levels, but also during the next bear market, we are just coming down to the tops that we had for now. So that means that maybe during the next bear market, the bottom will be at around 60k, like the first local top that we got for now. So if we're gonna repeat something similar like in 2013, then 60k will be the next bottom for the next bear market. And we're definitely headed towards way higher levels than the levels that we are seeing right now. And that's why I'm keep telling you, my friends, to accumulate more Bitcoin right now during this correction phase that we are seeing right now. Because if we're gonna repeat something similar like in 2013, then we definitely should buy as much Bitcoin as possible during this correction phase. So right now you can see that also here with this Pi Cycle indicator, we got here a sell signal right at around $61,000. This indicator worked for now, and I'm pretty sure that also for the real cycle top, this indicator will be very helpful, and we're definitely gonna keep an eye on this indicator in the future as well, once we are again overheating the price. But for now, we cooled off again this indicator, and we are still far away from a potential next sell signal, so we can take away this indicator for now and focus here on the potential targets here where Bitcoin most likely is heading to next. And you can see that the 200 daily moving average is right here at around 40k. That's why in my opinion here, at least we are getting a breather or just start to consolidate along the 200 daily moving average, similar like we did in 2013. And you can also see that we are starting to close now weekly candles below the 20 weekly moving average that currently is here at around 50k. So if we are having now the 20 weekly moving average as a resistance, then we should expect that Bitcoin is not able again to close weekly candles above 50k, same like we did in 2013. And as long as we are not able to close again weekly candles above this moving average, we most likely are heading lower or just go sideways before we are done with this correction phase or with this accumulation phase. And then we gear up again towards new all-time highs here for Bitcoin. So if we are now entering into this correction phase, this could be just the beginning, my friends, and we just should be patient and try to accumulate more Bitcoin the lower we go, because this is, in my opinion, not the cycle top for this bull run. And also based on the stock to flow model price, we are still perfectly on track. Currently, we are even dipping below this blue line. But at the end, we should be recovering pretty fast here and see Bitcoin going completely nuts here towards the end of the year. So I'm still very, very bullish for Bitcoin, and that's why I'm still looking for good buy opportunities and long opportunities. This is not the beginning of a bear market. This is just a prolonged correction phase that can take several days, weeks, and maybe even months before we definitely gonna recover from this accumulation or correction phase. And another very important indicator is here the hash ribbons indicator, because as you can see, we are still in this miner's capitulation phase. And as long as the lower line here is not crossing the upper line, we are still in danger zone and we're still not getting any kind of buy signal here. So we have to be patient until here we're getting a buy signal, same like we had in the past, that always signaled that Bitcoin is ready to move higher. And afterwards, we always have seen big continuations to the upside. So as long as here we're not getting a buy signal, I still think that Bitcoin is not ready to push higher. And that's why I think that this correction phase will take more days and weeks here until we are definitely out of the woods and can look forward towards new all-time highs. So this indicator for me right now is one of the most important indicators to time when Bitcoin should be ready to push higher and when we should be going again all in into Bitcoin. So don't freak out, my friends. Bitcoin currently is in this correction phase. Take it as a good buy opportunity for the long term. We will most likely head lower sub 40k here in the next coming days. But once this correction phase is done, we should be looking forward towards new all-time highs and potentially reach our cycle top, in my opinion, towards the end of this year. And another important indicator that you can also use for yourself is the Keltner channels, because thanks to the Keltner channels, we can predict more or less where Bitcoin could be creating another lower high if we're gonna see a breather. Usually it's always the top of the Keltner channels, and you can see that this is coming very fast down. It's currently here at around 56k. So if we're getting here a breather, same like we had here after we were closing a couple of daily candles below the Keltner channels, we just came to the top of the Keltner channels. I told you that this is a potential lower high target and also rejection area, because once we were starting to close daily candles below the Keltner channels, usually this signals that we are back in a downtrend here in the daily time frame, and we should expect the top of the Keltner channels as a resistance and see continuation to the downside. Exactly the opposite from what we had here in the past during our bull run from March 2020 until now. We always closed daily candles above the Keltner channels and bounced right at the bottom of the Keltner channel. So you can see here perfectly that we were in this nice uptrend. We always could bought here right at the bottom of the Keltner channels. Until then, of course, we topped out, and right now we are seeing exactly the opposite. We are starting to close daily candles below the Keltner channels, and we have now the top of the Keltner channels as a resistance. So as long as this is the case, I'm expecting here continuation to the downside. But once all indicators are again flashing to buy and we are also able to close daily candles above the top of the Keltner channels, we should be out of the woods, and afterwards we should expect again big continuations to the upside towards new all-time highs. But until then, I'm afraid that we most likely are heading lower or go sideways for many days and weeks before we're definitely out of the woods. And now we can also have a look here into the Ethereum price action, because as you can see, yesterday we got saved here by the 20 daily moving average, and also right now it's holding as a very strong support. So if Ethereum is able now to close this daily candle above $3,500, I'm expecting also here a potential breather to the upside to retest the 9 daily moving average here at $3,800. And also for Ethereum now, we have to look if we're gonna create here lower highs in the daily time frame and lower lows, then most likely also here we are heading lower, even though the chart is still looking extremely bullish here for Ethereum, and we could expect also here new all-time highs very soon, especially if Bitcoin is getting a breather. But if Bitcoin continues to plunge, especially below 40k, then I'm afraid that also here on Ethereum we could see a complete retracement back down towards the main support that we have here from this big channel, and this is right here at around $2,400. This is, in my opinion, the worst case for Ethereum, that we could have a complete retracement back down towards $2,400. But since we are still looking extremely healthy here, way better than over on Bitcoin, I still think that here we could see explosive moves to the upside if Bitcoin is just going sideways now, or even have a breather towards this 53 to 54k target. So here also in my own indicator, you can see that the RSI is cooling off here in the daily time frame. If we have a nice bounce here at the 50 level, I'm pretty confident that Ethereum could recover here pretty fast. So I'm still way more bullish here for Ethereum than over on Bitcoin. I think Bitcoin will just go sideways or lower here in the next coming days, even after a potential breather. But Ethereum is still looking extremely healthy, and here we are still maintaining very important supports here, especially in the daily time frame. And another bullish thing that could fire up such a breather, especially for Bitcoin, is the DXY, because the DXY is still falling. We are still in a downtrend here, and as long as the DXY is not having any major big pump towards the 200 daily moving average, or maybe even go back in an uptrend here in the daily time frame, I think the chances are very high that we could see Bitcoin stabilize here between 40 to 50k before we are ready again to push higher towards new all-time highs. And while the DXY is still falling, we are seeing currently Nasdaq having a nice push to the upside. We are right now touching a very important resistance level right here at the 50 and 9 daily moving average at $13,400. Although the RSI is now coming very close to the 50 level. So if Nasdaq is able to push and close daily candles again above $13,400, also here it's very likely that we could come up here to test the 20 daily moving average and maybe even push higher, especially if the RSI is going back above the 50 level. And if Nasdaq is able here to recover, then this could be also a good sign for Bitcoin that we're gonna stabilize here between 40 to 50k, and after this correction and accumulation phase, that we could gear up here towards new all-time highs very soon if Nasdaq is also creating here new all-time highs in the next coming days and weeks. So I know that right now in the markets the sentiment is quite bearish and it's very hard to huddle through when we are dipping down. But you should get used to these kind of bigger corrections as soon as possible, because especially here in the crypto space we always have big volatility. Sometimes we are seeing big crashes down towards important supports, and at the other hand, once we are going again completely parabolic to the upside, we always see big gains and big pushes towards completely new levels. So if you want to have those big kind of gains, then you should be strong enough to hodl during these correction phases or even buy more Bitcoin, because for the long term and for the long run you should be doing fine like that. And before I gonna wrap this up, I just want to show you again here the monthly time frame, because I told you in April that we got here a confirmed sell signal in the monthly time frame, same like we had in December 2017. And I told you, since I don't expect that this is now the cycle top for Bitcoin for this bull run, I just expect that the price could come back down to retest the two most important moving averages in the monthly time frame. First here the 9 monthly moving average currently at $35,000, and then here in the worst case scenario the 20 monthly moving average at $21,000. So both moving averages could be tested and Bitcoin would still remain in an uptrend. So even if we would come back down towards $21,000, Bitcoin would be still looking extremely bullish here in the bigger time frames, especially here in the monthly. But I just don't think that it's very likely that we could reach this $21,000 with this correction phase here. Sooner or later we will come down to test also the 20 monthly moving average, but with this correction phase I think latest here at the 9 monthly moving average currently here at around $35,000 we should see the bottom, and then of course a big bounce to the upside in my opinion, because this is by far not the cycle top and we're gonna go towards new all-time highs latest towards the end of this year. And something I completely forgot to cover is here in the CME chart, because we have now a new CME gap up to $49,000. Also the one that we created up here at around $62,000 is still opened and not filled. So we now have two CME gaps above of us. So most of the times those CME gaps are getting filled quite quickly. We still have a lot of CME gaps also below of us. One is right here at around $24,000 and the smaller one here at $19,000. If they are getting filled, in my opinion, it's not very likely. Also, already a lot of time have passed since we created these CME gaps. So the fresh ones are here above us. And that's why I think that Bitcoin most likely is just coming down towards a 200 daily moving average, consolidate somewhere there, and then continue towards the upside again to of course close these two CME gaps above of us, and maybe those two gaps here at $24,000 and $19,000 will never get filled. But as you know, never say never. Who knows? In my opinion, it's not very likely that they are getting filled, but just that you have that in your radar, they are still not filled down here, and usually almost all bigger CME gaps are getting filled. So let's just hope that we are not coming down to those levels, because of course that would be a huge crash. And this is for sure something that no one is expecting right now, that Bitcoin could fall again towards 20k and lower. So I still remain more with the scenario that we're gonna repeat something like in 2013, that we're most likely gonna find a bottom here along the 200 daily moving average before we are gearing up again towards new all-time highs, and that Bitcoin most likely is not gonna dip way below $35,000. So with that said, guys, we're gonna wrap it up for now. If you like the content, make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe to the channel. I do daily TA videos, and a big shout out goes also to our great crypto trading chat over on Discord. If you want to join our Discord trading chat, then make sure to use the invitation link that you find down below here in the video description. Once you have clicked on this invitation link, then go here to read first and click on this thumbs up button to confirm that you are human and not a bot. Then you have free access to the trading chat, and this is also the place where you can get access to my own indicator, which is giving you buy and sell signals. If you're interested, then contact me here on Discord, because a small donation is needed to get access to it. Otherwise, just get a YouTube membership, then you have access to the live stream directly here on YouTube. And another big shout out goes over to Bitsgap, because Bitsgap is offering to our community the Pro plan for 14 days completely for free. This is an all-in-one trading platform where you can connect all your exchanges to one place. Then you can run trading bots on them or also do arbitrage. They are very profitable. I also did a tutorial video that is popping up at the end of this video. So check it out if you're interested, and sign up with the link down below here to get the Pro plan for 14 days completely for free. And if you are profitable with that, then you can upgrade to a monthly plan, which is starting by only $19 a month. So thank you again very much for watching, my friends, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.